Here you can see two yuccas blooming on our property. And I opted not to eat them when they were young, so that when they grow up a little bigger, I can eat the flowers and see how that is.
Well, I'm back in Santa Barbara, hanging out with my friends at our favorite restaurant where we used to eat when we lived here all the time. And yeah, it kind of sucks. It's not as good as it used to be.
Syrup. Like, put a lot.
Yeah, put some butter on there too.
Yeah.
Yeah, you want more?
Yeah, you know. I might just put some syrup on them, just because I can.
And, I got my breakfast. Slop. Cyrus told me last night that basically all my food looks like dog food. And a lot of it smells like dog food, too. Hands down, the worst thing about being in Santa Barbara is the showering situation. It just makes me so thankful I made a solar shower, because the ice cold showers really suck. It's gotta happen. Going to a wedding. Gotta present myself.
Gonna eat some tacos!
It's a good time to quit ZAP right now, dude.
These are actually ZAP approved.
ZAP approved.
Yeah, straight.
Because we're on an avocado ranch in Carpinteria at the wedding, and so I'm gonna eat it. It's always good to chase your avocado with an 8-month-old warm old English. Yeah. It actually looks like I'm like too much of a snob to drink a nice like Sierra Nevada keg beer, but I'm like, oh no, I bring my own beer to the wedding. Weddings are really awesome when you're not on ZAP, but they suck when you are on ZAP. Eat some every day.
Dog food. Dog food. I chew up my Sunday beer. I read about the rich I fear.
I have a little story to tell this week, which is that I got home from the wedding suffering from a 2-day hangover. And my neighbor, Derek, had an interesting story to tell me, which was that he was in his yard, in his robe, having some coffee, watering his plants in the morning when the fish and game green truck pulled up and a couple guys stepped out with, you know, their full regalia of weapons and body armor and who knows what else. Obviously, they were looking for me. Apparently, they received many phone calls about the article in the paper, and a lot of people are up in arms, apparently, about what I'm doing. So one of them left his card. I'm going to call this guy and figure out the lowdown on why they want to talk to me, I guess. Good morning, Brendan. This is Tyson. I received your message.
Hey, how you doing? Thanks for giving me a call back.
Yeah, definitely. I was out of town. I just got back last night.
Basically, all I wanted to tell you was to have a conversation with you about, you know, obviously what's legal, what's not, and just make sure we're on the same page. And I just want to make sure that you have a clear understanding of, you know, kind of the confines that you can work within as far as the law goes, and if, you know, you choose to go outside of that, I just want you to be aware of you being aware of what you're doing. And
yeah, definitely. And a lot of people were saying that I'm, like, trying to do this outside the law and all this, and it says right in the article that the only thing that I am spending money on is, like, my fishing and hunting licenses. So I don't know where everyone got that from.
I was wondering, what does your maybe Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday look like? Those days.
I'm totally open. Whatever's good for you, really.
Okay. How about Thursday, Burger and Bar at 10?
Okay, thanks a lot, Brandon.
All right, no problem. Look forward to talking to you.
All right.
Bye.
Bye. Thursday. Well, I have very good news from the greenhouse.
So last year I let out a bunch of green lacewing eggs, and they never really hatched, never really saw them. And then all of a sudden, they're just everywhere now. These little guys are awesome for eating up all your aphids or mealyworms, whatever. Look, there's one here. This little guy there. There's one over here. Look, there's another one right there. Another one down here. So, that should help with the struggling battle I've had with my aphids. And also, the greenhouse just sounds awesome with the green lacewings chirping away, echoing off the walls. Very good ambience for the jungle. Well, it would appear that my banana experiment was successful in both ways, because that thing sprouted back no problem. So you don't have to worry about killing your banana to get some water out of it. Well, here's all the fava beans that I didn't eat as they were maturing. Be sweet. I love favas. They're the best thing ever. Check this out. Remember the squash we were pollinating a month ago? There they are. Look at that. These rampicante squash are great because you can either eat them as zucchinis, like if you ate them right now, or you can let them become winter squash and they'll last all winter. They're really easy to peel, unlike pumpkins and some other winter squash. And you can just like cut off sections, and they really last well. They don't go bad. Whereas the pumpkin, like if you cut into like this section where it's hollow, and other squash too, then they tend to rot right away. These are my go-to. I love these guys.
I'm down here at the River Inn, supposed to meet up with the game warden. Sounds like he is declining to do an interview with me.
Well, I just returned from my meeting with the game warden, who is a very educated guy, much more educated than myself. He was very helpful in helping me figure out kind of the parameters of something that I should have taken a lot more time to figure out before I started. I naively kind of thought that, you know, like the main stuff, like, you know, deer and turkeys and quail and ducks and that kind of stuff was kind of regulated. Didn't think that there was a need to regulate, you know, shooting blue jays or pigeons or, you know, like eating snakes and lizards and all this stuff. Pretty much everything has a regulation. Even certain types of kelp are not prohibited, which kind of amazed me. I didn't think there was too many people out there eating kelp. The fish and game laws are extremely thorough, and I unfortunately seem to have run up against that in the experiment, being that I'm trying to enact a world with no law and absolute mayhem, which I absolutely don't want, and trying to educate people and learn myself on what I can do in civilized society. Brennan was very helpful. He not only gave me these awesome fishing game resources, which is much better than their website, which I've been using, which is just heinously confusing, but he also went through and dog tagged and put little notes on here and highlighted a bunch of stuff in these books. Look at this: reptiles, amphibians, and crayfish. And I'm kind of amazed that all this stuff is actually in here. I mean, like, they've really gone through and figured everything out. For example, those blue-belly lizards are also called western fence lizards. There's actually a limit. 9 through 13 have a limit of 25. So someone's going out there and getting these blue-belly lizards and eating them, and you can only have 25. Lizard on a stick. Kind of tastes like chicken, actually. Not as bad as I thought it would be. Another interesting one is up here, gopher snake, which I ate backpacking. Apparently you can have a limit of 4 of those. Being America, we have a law for everything. And today I learned that. Apparently they're still considering what charges they can bring against me, which isn't really that funny, but God, you gotta laugh sometimes. I'm just trying to survive, and that's gotten a lot more difficult today with the restrictions that I'm now feeling. I just want to eat something, and it looks like I'm gonna be eating a lot of lizards, I guess. Crayfish are on the menu, apparently. So there you go. obey the fishing game or complicate your life fairly severely. And I would like to comment that I was not trying to disobey them. I just underestimated the complexity of the fishing game bylaws.
I didn't know if that was your example or what.
See what I gotta deal with?
Weddings.
Island,
dude.
Weddings are the best thing.
Dude, look, look at the photographer.
Just one, dude.
Weddings are the best thing ever when you're not on Zap. Hey!
Look how close. That's cheating, dude.
Get it out of here.
Oh, it was in your mouth?
No. It was in his mouth.
Zap's
it was
over. Not.
It's over.
Zap is over.
He quit.
I was trying to save.
Alright, so lizards are like really fast, and they're pretty hard to get your hands on. You can make a grass noose, which will greatly increase your odds of catching one. Make sure you get a really long piece of grass that's really flexible. So you want to double your grass back over itself, and tie a slip knot around the base of it. Make sure you have the grass so it's not the very, very end, which is too weak and the knot will break, but it's not too far down, which will make it too stiff and it won't tighten. Then you can just check it and make sure it slides real easy and that it's not going to break.
I've spotted a lizard.
Look at that.
I have acquired the lizard with the grass noose.